Hello everyone, I'm Alex, and I'm one of the science kids. Now, if you've watched through the entirety of one of our videos, you know that our motto is, science is everywhere and in everything. And that's true, we stand by that. Everything we do and everything around you in this world can be understood or solved using the process of the scientific method. But that's in real life. What if we take the methods of science and the processes of the scientific method and apply it to, well, not real life? And that's the topic of today's video. We're going to be talking about the fictional universe of superheroes. Well, obviously science doesn't have to apply to these fictional universes, but what if it did? For example, let's take the superhero Flash, who is best known for a superpower of super speed. Flash's power is super speed. Now, there's a lot to dive in, but first, let's talk about how we run. How do we achieve our speed? Well, obviously, we need to use our muscles. Our muscles are how I move, but how do our muscles work? This right here is a cross-section of a human muscle, so it's what it looks like on the inside. Now, if you look inside of it, it has a bunch of little things inside of it called muscle fibers. These muscle fibers are composed of these things called myofibrils, and these are the key to how we move, because when a myofibril contracts or extends, the entire muscle contracts or extends. That's how movement works. Inside of these myofibrils are two important proteins called actin and myosin. Actin and myosin work together to pull the entire myofibril together. That's how the myofibrils contract. Now, usually the actin protein has something on it to prevent the myosin from pulling it. But when the brain sends a signal to your muscles to remove those things, the myosin is able to pull on the actin and the myofibril is able to contract. That's why when you run, your brain sends a signal to your muscles telling your muscles to contract. Okay, that's cool. But how do I become faster? Well, the key lies in some of the fastest animals in the world. One in particular, the cheetah. Cheetahs have special fibers inside of their muscles called fast twitch fibers. That actin and myosin process I was telling you about earlier, that process happens significantly faster in these fast twitch fibers. Now, cheetahs have a great proportion of these fast twitch fibers, but we don't have as many. We're able to use them. In fact, that's how some of the fastest people in the world, like Usain Bolt, are able to get so fast, by training themselves to use these fast twitch fibers. But they usually only work on a short period of time, and even that cheetah doesn't go nearly as fast as a Flash. Now, this process happens billions, trillions, quadrillions of times every single day in your body. It's happening right now as I'm speaking. It's even happening to you watching this video. You may not notice it, but there are movements happening across your body all the time. I mean, think about it. Blinking, swallowing, breathing, all of those are forms of movement, and muscles in your body are the ones that allow those to happen. So maybe in the future, with genetic engineering becoming more and more cutting edge as we speak, there's a chance that we may be able to modify our muscles so that we have more fast twitch fibers that we can access more frequently. So we could literally make humans faster. Probably not as fast as the Flash though. But we glossed over a point when we were discussing how muscles contract. In the process of myosin pulling actin, in order to remove those things blocking the myosin from grabbing onto the actin, you need a chemical called ATP. ATP is basically like the body's form of energy. How is ATP created? Well, ATP is created through a process called cellular respiration. And in order for that process to happen, you need food. But think about it. If you had that many fast twitch fibers that you'd have to go as fast as, say, the Flash, you would need so much ATP to power those fibers. So you need to eat a ton of food. So how much food? Well, let's say the fastest man in the world, Usain Bolt, who ran this speed in the Olympics, ate the amount of an average human man on that day, which is 2,000 calories. Well, let's scale that up to the Flash speed, which according to Google is 2,532 miles per hour, or Mach 3.3, which means 3.3 times the speed of sound. Well, if you scale up that 2,000 calories, what do you get? That's a lot of calories. Just for some reference for how many calories that is 4,373 carrots, 1,166 bars of chocolate, and 1,401 slices of cake. That is a lot of food. And just a brief reminder, we're only talking about a brief period of time of you running this fast. So even if you had all of that energy, you'd probably only be able to run this speed for a short period of time. But until we have more technology to be able to run this fast, I highly recommend not eating 4,000 carrots. Anyways, we hope you enjoyed this video. Stay tuned for our next videos. Don't forget to check out our website and social media in the description. And as always, science is everywhere and in everything. Except for superhero movies. Bye!